Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your current affairs through MCQ mode. So we discuss daily MCQs, so they are covered from your current affairs perspective. So today is 17 October 2019. So let's see what are the questions for today. So the first question is, Kurds, an ethnic group, are found in which of the following countries? First, Iran. Second, Afghanistan. Third, Armenia. Fourth, Iraq. Fifth, Syria. So we have to choose that in which of these countries Kurds have been found. So A, all of the above, B, 1, 2 and 5, C, 1, 3, 5, D, 1, 3, 4, 5. So friends, let me tell you, the answer is D, that is 1, 3, 4, 5. So solution is D. So basically Kurds are an ethnic group of 25 million to 35 million population, and they are the world's largest stateless ethnic group. So they are spread across different countries. Basically majority of them are Sunni Muslims, and some of them also follow other faiths too. So they live in highlands of southern and eastern Turkey, northern Iraq, northeastern Syria, northwestern Iran, and parts of south Armenia, and are a minority in each of these countries. So small communities also live in Georgia, Kazakhstan, Lebanon, and eastern Iran as well. So why this question has been in news? So why this question has been framed? Recently, the government of the Turkey has launched an assault on the Kurds of Syria. So to create a buffer zone, 32-kilometer buffer zone with the Syrian border. So basically, behind this entire scene. So Kurds basically demand a separate state for them, that is Kurdistan. Kurdistan is made up of five different regions, that is southeastern Turkey, northeastern Syria, northern Iraq, northwestern Iran, and southwestern Armenia. Sorry friends. So their demand is to get Kurdistan. So for this purpose, Turkey has launched assault on the Syrian Kurds, so that a buffer zone could be created, so that the Kurds of the Syria and the Kurds of the Turkey don't merge together to kind of, we can say, wage a secessionist war against the regime, Turkish regime. So that is the purpose. So you can read about it in more detail in today's Indian Express explained part. So more detail is given there. Now let's move to the second question. Second question is, consider the following statements about World Economic Outlook report. First, the report is released annually by International Monetary Fund. Second, the report this year projected Indian economy to grow at 7% in 2019. So which of the above statements are correct? Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is first. So it is basically released by International Monetary Fund, and growth for the fiscal year 2019 to 2020 is 6.1%, and 7% growth projection is for 2020 and not for the 2019 fiscal year. So only one is correct, so the answer would be A, that is one only. So solution is A. So as I told you, IMF report, this is basically, this has projected India's growth rate at 6.1% for the current fiscal year. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about island Tholuggi. First, it is among the chain of islands in North Pacific Ocean. Second, recently a Chinese enterprise has got a lease of 75 years for undertaking development of the island and its surroundings. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. Let me tell you friends that first statement is incorrect, because it is not in North Pacific Ocean, but rather it is in South Pacific Ocean. But yes, second statement is correct. So this question has been picked up from a news article that has appeared in Indian Express of today on the world page. So the solution is B. So basically Tholuggi Island has been, China has got a lease over this island to develop it and its surroundings. So many regional players, including America and Australia and other countries that are there in the region, they see this move as a traditional Chinese policy to give we can say a huge amount of money to the countries, to the smaller countries, so that to lure them into the we can say into their into its trap, so that it can build its military and strategic assets there. So basically, this that's why this a question has been framed. So you can read about in more details by pausing the video. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about recently released Global Hunger Index report. First, the report is released annually by Welt Hunger Hilfe and Concern Worldwide. Second, the index covers three dimensions of hunger, that is inefficient caloric intake, child undernutrition and child mortality. Third is, India has been ranked 98 among 117 qualifying countries. So which of the above statements are correct? Let me tell you, friends, that only two statements are correct, that is first and second, because third is not correct. India has been ranked 102 and not 98. So the answer is A, that is 1 and 2 only. So this Global Hunger Index report, so it ranks countries on a 100 point scale. So 0 represents the best countries, that is no hunger, and 100 being the worst. So values less than 10 reflect low hunger, values from 20 to 34.9 indicate serious hunger, and values from 35 to 49.9 are alarming, and values of 50 or more are extremely alarming. So what is Global Hunger Index? So it is a peer-reviewed publication released annually by Welt Hunger Hilfe and Concern Worldwide. So it basically measures hunger on three dimensions, that is undernutrition, and then child insufficient caloric intake, and child undernutrition, and then child mortality. So insufficient caloric intake is calculated using undernourishment indicator. So it undernourishment basically is calculated by the share of population that is undernourished, reflecting insufficient caloric intake. So then comes your child undernutrition. Child undernutrition is calculated by child wasting and child stunting. So child wasting is basically the number of children below the 5 years of age who have a low weight for height. And then child stunting is low height for age. So low height for age reflects child stunting. And then child mortality is basically the mortality rate of children under the age of 5. So key findings are, the worst country is in terms of hunger is Central African Republic. So other thing that the report highlights is that it is becoming difficult to feed because of the climate change, because productivity is falling all over the world. And there are also many other impacts of climate change on agriculture, like floods and droughts. And then though there has been progress in reducing hungers, but the gains are now being threatened. So this is a serious concern, and severe hunger persists in many countries across the many regions across the world. So you can see about India, the details about India, that India has been ranked 102, and neighboring countries to bag better sports, that is than India, that is Sri Lanka, Nepal, Pakistan and Bangladesh, all are better performers than India. So then India bagged the top spot in child wasting rate in the world with an increase of 4.3% percentage points in 9 years. So then when it comes to stunting in children under 5, the countries are a dip, but it's still high, that is 37.9% in 2019 from 42% in 2010. Then you can read about more concerns by pausing the video. So obviously it will be difficult for us here to discuss all the details. So now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, child wasting refers to low weight for height. Second, child stunting refers to low height for age. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So friends, it is an easy question, because already we have discussed the explanation of the above question, that is the fourth question. So the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. That is, child wasting refers to low weight for height, and then child stunting refers to low height for age. So for explanation, you can check the fourth question. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about One Nation, One FASTag scheme. First, the plan aims to integrate the collection of toll digitally and ensure seamless mobility of vehicles across India. Second, the payment will be collected by National Payments Corporation of India. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are correct. C, both 1 and 2. So the answer is C. So it aims to integrate the collection of toll digitally and ensure seamless mobility of vehicles across India. And yes, payments will be collected by National Payments Corporation of India. So it is basically, it will be mandatory from 1st December 2019. So the features are basically, scheme will be implemented from December 1, 2019, and it can be availed upon activation by new cars having radio frequency identification tags on national and state highways throughout the country. So basically it aims to end the practice of carrying cash with oneself while moving on national highways, because tolls have to be paid. But this will ensure that these tags or these stickers, radio frequency identification tags or stickers, are fitted on the mirrors or on the windscreen of vehicles, and then the tolls will identify the vehicle, and then they will the payment will be then transferred digitally, and there will not be any need to stop at the toll and to pay the toll. So this program is the payment is made as part of National Electronic Toll Collection Program. So National Payment Corporation of India collects the payments for it. So FASTag, basically, as I've told you, stickers will be affixed on the windscreens, and then radio frequency identification technology will be used to enable digital contactless payment of tolls without having to stop at all toll gates. So the tags are linked to bank accounts and other payment methods. So obviously, for example, if you are moving in a car and you have this sticker on the windscreen of your car, and then this tag will be given to you by linking your tag with the bank account of you and or through other payment methods. So when you will cross the toll, the payment will be automatically deducted from your bank account or other payment method, and it will be transferred to the toll authorities. And then this will also be, so FASTag is valid for 5 years, and it needs to be recharged only as per requirement. So why do we need this scheme? So according to National Highways Authority of India, so these devices will make passing through tolls considerably smoother, since drivers will no longer have to carry cash or to stop or make a transaction. So cameras at toll booths will take photos of passengers in a vehicle, which will be useful for the Ministry of Home Affairs, as there will be a record of vehicle's movement. Now let's move to the next question. Next question is, what was the theme of this year's World Food Day? A, combating climate change for a food secure future. B, our actions are our future, healthy diets for a zero hunger world. C, zero food waste. D, none of the above. So let me tell you, friends, that the answer is B. So World Food Day is celebrated every year on October 16th. So it was established by Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations in November 1979. So it aims to raise awareness on the issues of poverty and hunger. So theme is World Food Day 2019 of 2009. This year's World Food Day is, our actions are our future, healthy diets for a zero hunger world. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about offshore wind policy. First, it was released in 2014. Second, the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy is the nodal ministry for the use of offshore areas for this purpose. Third, for this, wind farms are proposed to be set up within an area of 200 nautical miles from the coastline. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So friends, let me tell you that only second and third statement is correct. First statement is incorrect. So the answer would be A. So the second statement is, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy is the nodal ministry. Obviously, because it is a wind policy, then New and Renewable Energy Ministry will be the nodal ministry. So then wind farms are proposed to be set up within an area of 200 nautical miles from the coastline. So solution is A. So it was released in 2015 to realize the offshore wind policy potential in the country. So more details are here. You can pause the video and can read the details. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements about nuclear suppliers group is incorrect? So please note the word incorrect. A, it is a multinational body concerned with reducing nuclear proliferation. B, it was set up in response to nuclear tests conducted by India in 1974. C, India is a member of this grouping. C, all are D, all are correct. So there is a typing mistake here. So D, all are correct. So we have to choose which of the statements is correct, incorrect. Let me tell you, friends, that one statement is incorrect, that is C. So India is not a member of this grouping. So C is incorrect. So the solution is C. So it is a multinational body concerned with reducing nuclear proliferation by controlling the export and retransfer of such material that can be used that can be applicable for nuclear weapon development purposes by improving safeguards and protection on existing materials. So NSG was set up in 1974 as a reaction to India's nuclear tests to stop what it called the misuse of nuclear material meant for peaceful purposes. So currently it has 48 members. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements regarding Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. First, it is a legislative mechanism to deal with activities that threaten the sovereignty and territorial integrity of India. Second, it was framed in 1967 and has been amended since then for two times. So the solution is C. So it is aimed at effective prevention of one only. So it has been amended since then for three times. Recently it has been amended in the session that recently passed, that is the budget session in July. So it makes it a crime to support any secessionist movement or to support claims by foreign power to what India claims as its territory. So UAPA framed in 1967, it has been amended thrice since, first in 2008 and then in 2012 and then in 2019. So here is a mistake, typing mistake, sorry for that. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion. And if you like the questions, if you like the video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly, friends, if you want to access various resources, public resources that are shared by us, then you are more than welcome to join our Telegram channel, on which we have more than 13,000 subscribers. So the Telegram channel, the link of it is shown on your screen and will also be provided in the description box. And you can also visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, to get access to various public resources that we have for the purpose. So if you have any doubts, queries, you can mail us at this mail, or you can also contact us at the given contact number. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends.